transition. That's why we're telling the people of the UK, why can't we come there? It is because the people, not only Ghayasuddin, not only Jahangir Muhammad them, but the whole other team on the same governmental team, all of them on the same team. I'm used to people on the same team starting stuff, you know. They're on the same team. That's why, with all the threats from the police and being beat up and all of that, not a single telephone call. And to get those articles in there, which is a couple of years old now, no new stuff, no, you call?
No follow-up,
no help, no aid, no assistance. When I went to some country too last year, everybody knew the situation. I'm not gonna call a name, but within a month or so, I'm gonna point out all the big shots. Y'all better hurry up and do something, because this is just a warm-up. We're not gonna allow y'all, this is the Islamic movement, man. They got people dying and crawling through mud for this Islamic movement, and you think y'all we gonna turn it over to girlified Muslims with governmental backing? So sorry, not this time, not if we're alive. We don't believe, see, y'all got the wrong idea. See, we knew Dr. Kalim Siddiqui's position. He's a leader, a real leader. What else comes with that? Automatically surrounded by niggas and the police, whether they speak Urdu or Arabic, they still gonna be. He's gonna be surrounded. It's the rule, see? Well, y'all made the mistake was you didn't know some of the Negro stuff that we've been doing. Look here, this is a traditional Panther regalia, black leather jacket, Stingy Brown. Now, that's not the ones they was wearing. This is tailor-made Andrew Gross. That's an inch and a half Stingy Brown. And a five-inch crown. That's a five-inch crown. It's not one of them flat tops that the other Negro wore. That's a real leather jacket, too. A little diamond ring ain't too much in it. But we still got our Free Huey stuff on there. And we had to come through that. Y'all don't know that's 1968. That's crunch time. You got to read American history. 1968, what was the crunch? This is 1970 right here. They had already killed everybody with that uniform on. So what do you do? You fool them and you put this uniform on. Now that, they just send you to the penitentiary and make fun of you for wearing this one. But guess what? As long as they think you that, you and big boy, you got it going on. And you can help all the people. Like when I went into, a year after this, when I went into exile, I didn't go to the island somewhere. I went to Algeria. Why? Because of the revolution. And we helped the revolution. You know, let me see if I got a few more. You can't see the mink in here. You see why I set it down in the back? Because it's got a 300-pound machine back there for 11-channel telephone. Now y'all got a little handheld telephone. But if you want a telephone in your car, you have to have a Pro-Am. It's got a little antenna, you probably can't see it. And you can see the headrest, and you can see all the other back in the back seat is me. Long as the white man think that's the way you're going, and he thought that's what he was doing. Therefore, we learn how to survive and how to trick the old European. We have to trick him. So, when we went to Algeria, you ask anybody, you still find Pete O'Neill, he's in Tanzania. Sekou Diga just got out of the penitentiary the last year. He's up in New York, ask him. Did Imam Musa bring big money over there? And did he leave, and when he came back the next time, he brought even bigger money? But the only thing is, you had to find the Negroes. They wasn't in Algeria no more. The Great Rebellion. In fact, when I came to have money, they was off. They was broker than they had ever been. I didn't know it till later, but that was a godsend. They was flat broke. They wanted to leave. They didn't have no money. And the money I brought up, they used it. Everybody could go where they wanted to go, which they did. So, but I remember what I told them. I said, well, if we're going to have a revolution, we had a meeting. The elders was there. All the brothers was there. And we want to have, my suggestion was, well, y'all going to do, in order to fight the white man, we're going to need bullets and weapons. So here's how we can do it. We can set up an international dope smuggling outfit. And now, on principle, we can't do that. No, no, that's terrible. Of course, now, that was in the door, but after, you know, the other half, that's not a pretty good idea, but, you know, we can't get it past a central committee. I said, don't worry about it. I'll go do it myself. I just go do it myself. And that's what I did. I went around the world, had a good time. Then I wound up in South America. After I made a few big runs, I went back to Algeria. No Negroes. No Negroes. So I figured, well, I went to my regular spot, went all the way to Tanzania. And some of them went there, and that's where my best friend wound up. So we just left something behind for people to work with, and then came back here, South America, set up a big shipment, went to Mexico, stayed down there, because see, if you got a Mexican border, people don't know. I was just looking at the paperwork the other day. Hermosillo is the capital of the state of Sonora in Mexico. And there's a great Sonora desert right below Arizona, California, Arizona, and New Mexico. It is hot there. But if you want to bring dope, we used to call it the Negro route, and get it through with no trouble, you just bring all the dope you want from Colombia to Mexico. And let it cool off. It gets you a couple of spots and you let the dope cool off. Then you're in Sonora. The border is right up there. So you send a package across, send a package across, send a package across. Pretty soon you didn't send plenty of packages across. You can't lose nothing. If you lose one little shipment, it ain't nothing. Because you got a whole reservoir. I quit right in the middle. Right in the middle, somebody's rich, boy, I tell you, they're as rich as they can be. Because it was paid for in there. And I quit. Now I know. Now my friends in California know I quit right in the middle. Why? Because Islam had kicked in. What is the message? It's happened before. If you make this message, you ain't gonna never, if you make this shipment, that money gonna be so big, you gonna be so dug in, you ain't gonna quit. And you know it, so you quit. That happened again the last time I went to the penitentiary. Just being tempted, but Islam is so serious, you know, that you put yourself into the penitentiary. I told the brothers once, The last time I went to the pen, it's like I volunteered. We call it throwing rocks at the penitentiary window, let me in. That's exactly what I did that. No problem. I just want to do this one, then we're going to wrap it up. Revolution from Egypt to the Americas. Revolution from Egypt to the Americas. Oakland and the American Islamic Revolution. This is from a white folks. I just got this off the internet. I didn't make this up. This coming, you can probably still get it. So they have here Oakland and the American Revolution. This is Imam Jamil Al-Amin. For those in the UK don't know, remember this is H. Rap Brown. In the civil rights struggle, there was Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, Stokely Carmichael, and H. Rap Brown. This is H. Rap Brown. Imam Jamil Al-Amin. Long story short, he's in prison for the rest of his life. We don't have time to go through the details. This was his second in command. Imam Luqman from Detroit. He was shot either 18 times or 21 times, different numbers. The brother that washed the body said 18 times. And the police said 21 times, or vice versa. I don't remember. But anyway, he was shot,
My whole life.
He was shot. Then they have me, yours truly, dear Musa. What does that mean? It's very simple. That is your homeboy, he's in the pen for the rest of his life. We done killed him. If you don't shut up, a nigga, you are next. Of course, I have my own opinion. Here's what I say. I might be able to find my opinion on all of that. They can kiss my, as we say in English, black ass. You know what that spells, of course. That's my attitude. It's been like that. And it's a blessing. That means you're not scared of the European and you're not scared of his structure. So if you're not scared of, let's say, the white man, how in the hell am I going to be afraid of my own brothers, that work for him? And they sweetie pie Muslims. One of these Muslims on the picture, something happened to him. He urinated on himself. Yes, he did. He's a tattletale. And he didn't have no, he urinated. I ain't gonna tell you who it was, but it ain't me. It wasn't Dr. Zadig. It wasn't him. Just two other. So you figure, he peed on himself. Now, Mark Bagamica said that, and him and Mark Bagamica is on the same team. So Mark Bagamica said no. I trust him dearly. Yes, I do. Now, what does this all mean? Majlis Ashura Islamiyya Free Britannica was destroyed from the inside. It was a setup from the very beginning. That's the way the Islamic movement is in the world. Right now, there's a separation. It's not only on TV with what Saudi is doing in Yemen and what's happening in Bahrain and what's happening in the eastern provinces and what's happening in Europe and what's happening here. The whole movement is going through evolution. We can't control or manage what's going on in other areas. But our area, in the United States, we're going to do our job. Ain't nothing they can do about it. We have the same thing we've always offered the government. You can shoot us in the head or go on about your business. Otherwise, I don't know nothing you can do to stop nothing. You know, maybe some poison or something. But that's the only thing you can do. It's our honor, it's our privilege, and it's our duty. There's no greater job in the world to be a petty student of history and to live during this period of time. And this sounds strange, and I'll talk to you about it later, but our people here know that we have the pulse of the world. They don't even, when we tell them about stuff, they look up like at the last conference group. That's right. They do it all the time. Almost every time something is going on serious, they can't look at no Arab Spring and outline it step by step. It's going to go to this stage, it's going to go to that stage, and now here we are at that stage. That stage will produce a regional vision. And that regional vision will lead to the victory. Okay, just because it's years ago, just because it takes that, they don't do that. They don't do that. That means there's something special going on. And we know that. That don't bring on arrogance. That just bring on gratefulness. And right now, the simplest of things is telling God, well, let's see what we got going on here. Here's what they didn't want. They didn't want big, well-trained Arab armies with command structures. They didn't want leadership structures. They didn't want transportation systems. They didn't want da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And that's what they got. Right now, in years past, Iran was all by itself on one side. Now you have strategic alliance. Strategic alliance. Iran, Iraq, Syria, and dear Russia. You said dear Russia. Okay. So what you got Saudi Arabia and this other crew on the other side? Don't make no difference. When you're not by yourself, and when you control whole swaths, you have to look at the map. Iran is 1/5 of 1/4 the size of the United States. I've driven around. You pop in Iraq, you pop in Syria, hey, you got a lot of time. Then you take 30% of people of Pakistan, and she is 30% of the people of Afghanistan, and she is. Bahrain, 80%. Nothing you can do about it. It's got to go revolution. Only when? You can't do nothing with 80% of the population. You can kill people, you can do that, but it's too late. The minute there's a couple of little things they have to do, and as soon as they turn those knobs, that's it. They'll turn them soon, because these fools won't quit. Eastern provinces of Saudi Arabia, Hezbollah in Lebanon, hey man, this is not 35 years ago, this is a different world. And now for America, you have us here. Yes, you've got us, you've got the brothers. Yes, you do. Negro, 100% Negroes, card-carrying Negroes with Negro history. And they've taken their Shahada. They remember all the stuff you see on the movies and stuff, Muslim niggas and stuff. They know that. They know that. They just was old enough to live through it. Ain't nothing you can do about them. You can kill them, other than that, that's it. They ain't even thinking about it. They got clowns. Now I'm talking to y'all instead of them. Let's get back to this, to the original. Let's get back focus. We always talk about focus. That's what we do. So let's get back. I'm going to close by talking about the great role that Dr. Khalid Siddiqui played in the conferences. Those worldwide conferences produced all this. You know, just go through them, you know. These stayed current up until 10 years ago. If you read these, you'd be in on it. The last one was 1987. But if you knew what was in these, you could forecast anything. we need your help, UK. That's the main thing I want to tell y'all. Now y'all got enough money to help your brother now, you know that. And all of us over here, let's call ourselves the Velayati Faqih brothers. Ain't nobody, no more, I can't find no Velayati Faqih folks over here. I ain't found none. I don't care how much you like them, they still ain't pro-Velayati Faqih. They might be pro-diplomacy, pro this, that, and other. They're just not revolutionary. I don't know what else to say. And these are people that we went through the struggle. You're talking about struggling? Boy, look at here. We struggled together. But when you get in hot water, I think they say, you've been hot water, not us.
Every man
for himself, or them for themselves. They're Iranian nationalists. I didn't mean to call it that. They're Iranian nationalists. They believe in diplomacy, and they don't like Velayati Faqih. So we have to stop their behind, because they'll ruin everything. We're not against ho-humming with the Americans, but you got to know the Americans. I deal with Americans all the time. I like them. My friends are Americans, family, all.
Look at the deal they just concluded with Iran. I tell you what Americans do. They don't cross you.
I tell you what I told the people in Iran last year. I said, look, here's what you do. As soon as you finish signing the deal, I told them. Well, somebody said I said this, I don't know. They said that I told him not double cross him because he's going to double cross you. No, we got to stick that word. It's okay. He's going to double cross you first. You might as well double cross him because that's what you do. We signed. We are going to stick with our word. And I said, that's good. Okay. They didn't call and say, hey, man, we'll see you all right. They don't do that. Nobody does. The street prayer. The last thing I forgot to tell y'all, praying in the street is a diversion. Because you can't build community, structure, organization in the street. Why would you want to pray in the street when you had the biggest joint in the whole region, the IAC? Why wouldn't you have Juma there? Why would you want to pray in the street to get back? And you got, when I came here, it was hundreds of people still going out there. Why not just have Juma there and organize? I'll tell you something. I came here in 87, and I looked at the situation. I said, look, you be the big chief. I give allegiance, Bayer. I go everywhere in the States. I know you go a lot, too. I give you Bayer. You get on out there. That is the second one. One is a Negro I told this to. He didn't cotton to it. Neither did the Arab. I don't know what it is like. But now when one of our big basketball players come and they want to get Bayer, they take Bayer from him, but they won't take it from me. I don't know why. And then they flooded all their friends and these phony shields and stole all of the money. Good God Almighty. And won't even call on the phone. He was sending their family, their friends, their children. These people are nasty. Look, thank God I was a dope dealer. For me, thank God, because when I get my throat cut or stabbed in the back, I just go. But some of our people didn't come up through that, so it hurts some. Bad. No, it do. It hurt them. And it takes them out of the box. But like all the other stuff, we're saying these things now for timing. This is the time to do it. The other times, the Majlis Ashura Islamiyya, Free Britannica, it was bound to go. I didn't have any strength. I could have just hollered and tipped everybody off, but if I'd have tipped them off, I couldn't have manipulated them. And plus, Allah's in charge, but you may not believe it, but Allah guides you along, and Allah be hinting to you strong hints, okay? And you have to just let that ride. You can't do nothing about it. And you be saying, your heart be saying, oh man, that's gonna hurt them, that's gonna. But then Allah tell you, you gotta get up there. How are you gonna get there? You can't tip all them niggas off. You ain't gonna get nothing done. It is sad, but it's true. So now we're making the moves now, and we're going to Anfaru Tanfaru, go forward, whether equipped lightly or heavily, and struggle and strive in the way of Allah with your goods and depression. Right now, we're lightly situated, lightly equipped. And the lightest thing we're equipped with is money. Y'all see the thing, what it says, 4603 Benny Road. If you don't know a safe way to send us some money, get on a plane and bring it over. Well, they may not even let y'all in now. Good God Almighty, let's see, we'll figure out another way. We need millions of dollars, millions of pounds, euros, whatever y'all got. But we need a lot of money. We're gonna do our part. We're gonna do our part. We're doing our part right now. If you think this is a big drastic situation and we're too lighthearted about it, no, we're not lighthearted about it. That's what God gave us. You know, you remember all the conferences, the tragic situations I was talking about, doing it with humor. This is a gift from Allah. If we related the story the way it was and considered it the way it was, we would just be crying all day. So we can live in the most tragic situation and environment imaginable and be laughing at it. You got to laugh at it. If you consider it the way it is, you're gonna head home. I mean, fast. You ain't gonna let nobody come back. And this braggadociousness, you remember at Hunain, when they went out with a big army, 10,000 men almost, but they was elated with their crew, and the heat come on, everybody broke and ran. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam called him back, and he was talking to the people he was fighting. He said, "I'm Muhammad Abdullah." Da 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 da. He was talking good trash. Remember that? What he was saying. So when we say this is Big Hank talking, this is Abdul Ali Musa telling them girly-fied niggas in Oakland and these sissies here. Maryland trio. Now, I ain't gonna call their name, but they both got the last, two of them got the last name Khan. One is on this team, one is on the other team. And they control, and if you put the urinator in there, you got the University of Maryland trio, right? They got money, they got wealth. And you talking about abandonment. If you was brokenhearted type of person and you was just depending on somebody just to throw you a rope, my best friends, what they do is they measure the rope and they throw it to you, but it just to stop you from drowning. Those are my best friends. You can't get out of this situation, but you just won't drown or die. I'm telling you. And so I like them. They Those are the best. Hey, man.
You were talking about raising money?
Right.
What was it? Was it last week that the mosque got burned down in Texas?
Yes, yes.
They done raised $1 million already.
Yeah.
They raised $1 million. It ain't been a whole week.
Okay. Well, see, and then now, but see, our mosque is a Negro neighborhood, and they just pull guns on us. The police just beat us up when they feel like it. And they just punch holes in the roof. And they just steal equipment, hundreds of thousands of equipment. It's just, you can't talk about it. There's so much stuff. So, if y'all want to help the movement in America, help us and get a little crew together, have you do it. But we do need a lot of help. And you can trust a brother. Yes, you can. Don't worry about it. We ain't gonna buy no Cadillacs like the Negroes used to do. We ain't gonna run off with no white women. We ain't gonna do none of that. We don't do that stuff. We just don't have no record of it. So you wanna help the movement? I'm gonna tell you later on about how the brothers tried to trap me with half white, half Indian women. Cause see, they know they like light women too. I'm gonna just, not gonna stay long. You know a Pakistani cut off his arm to marry a light Pakistani. Yes, they will. Y'all from Pakistan? Who's sweeping the streets? All them little darkies. Now you know I've been there and seen. I know it don't have nothing to do with color. You the Iranians, them Turkish looking girls with the hazel eyes. What about them? Why you don't like the black-haired Persian-looking girls? Why you don't like them? I know you like them since you have to. It ain't but a few green-eyed, but you'd give your whole arm to have them, wouldn't you? Yes, you would. And then y'all have tried to trap me with a few of them girls, and that haven't worked. Cause y'all thought this is a nigga. Yes, you did. I remember all of them. I done told some of the people here about it, you know. So you don't have to worry about the brother. Plus, I'll be 72 in a few more days. To tell the truth, I like work better than I do girls. I do. I just like work better. I like working out. Now, if I just have to mess around, I just will. But, shoot, I like being by myself. I almost love it. You know, it's nice. You know, and at a certain age, you ain't juiced up no way about, you can be if you have to, but you ain't, just naturally Googling it everything, and you know. So I'm gonna spend your money wisely. And I'm not gonna mess up nothing. I did all my messing up. Well, I didn't do much messing up. But whatever messing up I did it when I was young. I thank y'all very much. Look at that. There's a rock bar. Look at that smile. See, that's a good nigga there. That's the rock bar. See? And you ought to see the white man over here, because I keep one everywhere. When he see that, I had a big poster like that. Do you know somebody had last month broke in the car and stole a doggone poster? And as if I can't get it blew up again. They just didn't want me to have that poster when we making talks. If you knew how much fun we had here, you would just want to be here with us. But you can't, so just help us become more successful. We're going to hook up America. Don't worry about America. You send us enough help, we're going to whoop them anyway. Because it says go forth by the crooked light of heaven. The whole trend, I close with this. If you don't know exactly what's going to happen, it's no problem. But if you know the trends, which way things are going. If there's enough trends going a certain way, you can't change a trend overnight. It's a trend. When the Titanic hit the iceberg, it started a trend. What was that? The ship sinking. After it kept on going a minute, that's it. You can get off, you can light a bonfire, it don't make no difference. The Titanic is going down. The American ship of state has hit an iceberg, and the Titanic was going too fast in dangerous waters, right? This clown over here, his favorite statement is, damn the torpedoes, full speed ahead. He don't care nothing about nothing. He been in office 2 weeks, and it's almost over now. Good God Almighty. So thank y'all very much. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.